وقرن في بيوتكن ولا تبرجن تبرج الجاهلية الأولى وأقمن الصلاة وآتين الزكاة وأطعن الله ورسوله إنما أهل البيت ويطهركم تطهيرا
هنا فضيلة الشيخ الإمام العلامة المحدث ديار اليمنية هو أبي عبد الرحمن أبي عبد الرحمن مقبل ابن هادي الوادعي رحمه الله تعالى. يقول السائل: ما حكم خروج النساء متزينات متأطرات لصلاة التراويح؟ معتقدات أن هذا تطبيق قول الله تعالى: خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد. The great scholar of hadith and the possessor of high knowledge, Abi Abd al-Rahman Muqbil ibn Had al-Wadi'i of the Republic of Yemen, he was asked, what is the ruling concerning women leaving out, leaving out of their houses, leaving out beautified, perfumed, going out for the prayer of Ramadan after Isha, with the belief that this is in accordance with the statement of Allah, and take your beautification at every masjid. What is the ruling concerning that, O Shaykh?
وما حكم خروج النساء متزينات متعطرات لصلاة التراويح معتقدات أن هذا تطبيق لقوله تعالى خذوا زينتكم عند كل مسجد؟
هذا إذا خرجت متعطرة فالرسول صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم رخص للنساء في الخروج إلى المساجد بعد في العشاء بشرط أن يخرجن كفلات، أي لابسات الثياب التي هي غير لافتة للأنظار ولا متطيبات وأبو هريرة يقول أن النبي صلى الله عليه وعلى وسلم قال: أيما امرأة خرجت ليجد متعطرة ليجد ريحها فهي زانية. نعم.
The Sheikh, he said, rahimahullah ta'ala, that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam gave special permission for the women to go out of their houses, to leave out, going to the various places of worship, the masajid, after Salat al-Isha. After Salat al-Isha, which is the time for Salat al-Tarawih, the prayer in Ramadan. And then the Shaykh, he continues and he says, they may go out if the going out is without a type of clothing that draws attention to one that may look, with the condition that the garments that they wear are not attractive and that they are not perfumed. And that Abi Huraira radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he mentioned that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam, he stated, any woman that leaves out perfumed in order that men may look at her, in order that men may smell her, then this woman, she is a fornicator. She is a zaniya. And this was taken from the recording of the Sheikh out of his book as well, Kitab Fada'ih, Fada'ih, Fada'ih wa Fada'ih, that which is scandalous, from the scandalous things, on pages number 86 and number 87, pages 86 and 87 of the book of the Sheikh Muqbil ibn Hadi Wadi'i, rahimahullah ta'ala. Wa nas'al Allah an iskanahu jannatul firdaus a'la. وأن يحافظ على دياره ودعوته وطلابه ومشيخه إنه الجواد الكريم إنه على كل شيء قدير. وأسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى to preserve the Sheikh's da'wah, his place that he made for da'wah, his students, those that graduated to the level of Sheikh or Alam. And we ask Allah سبحانه وتعالى to have mercy on the Sheikh رحمه الله تعالى. الحمد لله رب العالمين.